All right, good evening, guys. It's actually day after Thanksgiving, and I wanted to set some rabbit traps, and we've come down here to this spot at the end of our driveway where I catch several rabbits a year, and got out of the truck, and this rabbit run up on the bank, and I shot it and killed it with my pistol. So we're going to set some traps today, but I just made this box trap last week. We tried to upload a video on it, and it wouldn't go up. But this is a regular old-fashioned box trap like a lot of kids set in eastern Kentucky for many years, catching rabbits as a young boy. It works pretty simple. It's got a little mechanism to keep the door closed. This little rod goes down and hooks. And we'll bait it with an apple. And whenever the rabbit goes in the box and it just touches that little old piece, the door closes. And that mechanism keeps it closed. So you're allowed 4 rabbits a day in eastern Kentucky. We are going to set this trap and these 2 traps. And so we'll bait them and see if we can catch some rabbits in the morning. But I'll set it up and we'll show you how we set one up, okay? Okay, so I wanted to show you guys something to look for when you're scouting for a place to either trap rabbits or hunt rabbits. You can see these little bushes. They've really like these mimosa trees. They'll even chew on, I think these are little sumacs or something, but they will, if you can see, they nibble the bark off of the bottom of them, and they eat on that stuff during the winter because there's not a lot of vegetation right now, so they'll eat on bark of trees, real tender bark. So that's just something to look for. We got a box trap right here we're going to set. So okay, so I just got this box trap set, the one that we've built. Something I want you guys to know is always make sure that this trap is set solid on the ground. For one thing, if it's not, when the rabbit goes in, it's going to set the trap off. But it also makes the rabbit feel safer if the trap is solid. And so I've got an apple in the main back sitting behind the trigger. And hopefully we'll get a rabbit in this box in the morning. Let's set us 2 more sets. Okay, so we're putting in our second set and it's already set. This is a different type of trap. You've got 2 options. You can build a homemade wooden trap. Or you can purchase these live box traps, which are work very well. If you don't have the time to build an old trap, you can just go buy one of these traps. And so I've got it set. These work with a platform in the bottom, which is a pedal to set them off. It's baited in the back with my apple. I put some sticks around that apple just to make the rabbit have to dig past those sticks to get the apple to make sure he gets on the panel or on the paddle to set it off. And so he's got plenty of room to go in. I just laid some sticks around it to camouflage. So that's the second set. Let's put us 1 more set in. Okay guys, so I put my 3rd set in. Remember I said you're allowed 4 rabbits a day in eastern Kentucky. I usually set 4 traps. I've never had 4 traps full of rabbits in a night. So I just went ahead and set 3 because this is a small area. If I get 3 rabbits out of here, I'm probably going to stop, leave the rest for seed. But I've got this one set up. And so it's also, I wanted you to know that in Kentucky, your traps have to be at least 10 foot apart from each other. Setting rabbit traps in a thicket like this, I like to at least put them 20 yards a piece or something. That way they're just spread out good. But I've got this one camouflaged in decently. It's setting good and solid. Got my apple in the back. One more thing I want to tell you guys is, I usually don't run these once it starts snowing and if it's raining and it's cold, because these things will pretty much freeze up and a rabbit can go in and it won't even go off. So you want to do these whenever it's not really freezing rain or like icy cold outside. So we'll come back in the morning and maybe we'll see if we got a rabbit in here.